given since time immemorial time, and to be assigned. Ibig sabihin, the mystery of God is revealed through the body. Probably why the body man was made of female. That's the reason why God created us as made of female. So that we can image God's mystery of the world. Kung ayaw niyo maniwala na ganun nga naman, just think of the mystery of the incarnation. Diba? If we just celebrate Christmas, ano ba naman ang Christmas? The world made flesh and dwelt among us. Sabi ng Catechism, in the path of Jesus, we see our God made visible, and so we are caught up in the love of God whom we have seen. In the incarnation itself, the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us. There is the mystery of the incarnation, God took on a human face through the body and the humanity of Jesus. But if you come to think about it, my dear friends, Christianity is a religion of God's union with humanity. It is a religion of the Word made flesh. That is what Christianity is. At the heart of our Christian faith, we have the mystery of the incarnation. The Word was made flesh and dwelt among us. And the whole sacramental economy, the whole sacramental system of the Church flows precisely from the incarnation. It is through our bodies that God communicates His life to us. It is through we share God's divine life in baptism by bathing the body with water. We impose our hands, we lay our hands in the sacrament of confirmation, holy orders, and anointing the sick on the body of the person concerned. We confess our sins with our lips and receive and hear the spoken word of forgiveness in the absolution given by the priest. All these are mediated by the body. We eat and drink the body of God Christ. Man and woman are joined in the one flesh union in marriage. The whole sacramental economy of the Church. There is a body at the center of it. And therefore the body is a sign that points to a divine mystery. Now what is this divine mystery pointed to by the body? Through the fact that the Word became God in flesh, the body entered the world into the main world. It is a report to us through the main world. Okay? What is this divine mystery revealed to us by the body? Now, when we speak here of a mystery, we do not refer to a puzzle that cannot be solved. Mystery here refers to the fact. The mystery that we are talking about is the mystery hidden in God from all eternity, as St. Paul put it. It refers to the innermost reality of God and to His eternal plan for us, for humanity. Yan ang mystery na nag-uusapan natin. We came to know this mystery, we came to know the innermost being of God and this plan for us. Not because we have discovered it by our human logic, by our human study, but because God chose to reveal it to us in Scripture. God chose to reveal it to us. Now what is this divine mystery that we are talking about? Sabi ng Catechism, God has revealed His innermost secret. God Himself is an eternal exchange of love. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. And that He has destined us to share in that exchange. The Trinitarian communion. God is an eternal communion of persons. Communion happens when two or more persons give themselves in love to one another. And God is just that. An eternal communion of Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. We know the Father eternally gives Himself to and for the Son. In turn, that the Son eternally receives and gives His life to the Father. And the love that we share is the Holy Spirit who proceeds from the Father and the Son. And that is why we exist. than having sins, because God by nature is love, and love by nature expands its own communion. God did not have to create us, He did not need to create us, but the love of God is perfect and complete in itself. Yet, out of sheer goodness and generosity, God wanted to create other persons to share His own eternal exchange of love within Himself. Yan sa akin ng katikisan, God made us so that we can share His life with Him. So sa akin ng Panginoon sa Scriptures, I came with you my life, coming to the full. I came that your joy will be complete. In my Father's house there are many rooms. I'm going there to prepare a place for you. God sent His Son, that whoever believes in Him may have eternal life. That is the mystery revealed by our bodies. And the beautiful thing is, we are destined to participate in the divine communion of love, of the Blessed Trinity. The beautiful thing is that God, para hindi natin makalimutan yung plano ng Diyos, which is also our human destiny. God inscribed in our body, in our sexuality, in our own embodiedness of male and female, the call to participate in a created version of His eternal exchange of love, of His divine communion. Now think about that. Your own marital union is a call to participate in the very communion of God Himself. And this is the mystery revealed through our bodies. That God is a communion of love, and we are destined to share in that exchange. This is the mystery that the human body signifies right from the moment of our creation. And how we participate? By giving ourselves totally and freely to one another in that wondrous union that we call marriage. Later on, we will see how John Paul speaks of the nuptial meaning of the body. The nuptial meaning of the body means the body's capacity to express love and to express the self-giving of husband and wife to one another. We always use the word nuptials. Nuptials. Nuptial celebration. The wedding. The nuptials of so-and-so. That's what we mean by nuptial. God, capacity of the body to express love and self-giving. Imagine. God created that precise male and female so that we could image to some of the world by becoming a sincere gift to one another. In that one flesh union of marriage. Therefore, conjugal love, married love, and even sexual intimacy becomes an icon of the Trinity, an icon of the divine communion of three persons, the Father, the Son, and the Spirit. You know, nobody tells us that this is the case. When you listen to the TV television, when you read books, you go to Power Books, there's a whole section there, health and sex. They will never tell you. The pastor's unknown marriage family that we have done a life that parents and husbands and wives must do is an icon, a participation, an image of that divine communion. And that divine communion, by the way,